Hi, this is Pam from Firecracker Designs by Pamela, here to teach you a little bit about watercolor pencil. Ready? Here we go. Okay, today we're going to start with a turtle die cut. This is how the die cut comes to you. This is how it looks after I have stamped it with green stays on ink. Because I'm going to do watercolor pencils, I want to use an ink that is waterproof. So the first thing I'm going to do is take just a base color. This is a pretty light green, and I'm just going to color the whole turtle this nice shade of green. Once your turtle is all colored in with one color, we're going to start with a darker color, and this is a nice dark green. I'm just going to kind of hit underneath where I want it to look like it's lower and shadowed and separate to kind of give it a little more definition. So I'm going to hit all the way under the feet and the edge of the head, and then I'm going to do some of the markings up here just to give it a little more definition and around the edge like this. Once you've got all your nice dark green shading in, I want to add a little bit of blue just to give it a little more character. So I'm going to take this nice dark sort of a midnight blue and just kind of go around the edges here just to give it a little more oomph to it. Go around the outer edge here. Once you've got all your blue in, you're going to take your watercolor brush, and you can use any wet paintbrush, a fine tip paintbrush, or you can use an aqua brush, which is what I'm using today. This is an aqua brush. It's basically a barrel that holds water with a brush tip at the end. And you just squeeze it to get it started, to get the water to come down in. And then once you've got it wet, you're ready to go. So I'm going to now do some blending. And I'm going to start with my lightest color first. And then I'm going to pick up some of this dark color and sort of blend it up into the lighter color. And once you've got that all blended, it looks like this. I added a little bit of yellow to this, which I forgot to do in this sample, and then blended a little bit of yellow into it. So this is the finished turtle. So this is one of your options, just using watercolor pencils and a brush, aqua brush. And the second thing I want to show you is using this same technique, the same idea, but we're going to use twinkling H2Os. We're going to use twinkling H2Os. That's these little pots of paint that have sparkles in them. And I'm just going to take a water spritzer and spritz them to activate the paint. And I'm going to start with this green. This is called the lime green, which is a nice light color. And I want it good and wet because I don't want it so dark that it covers up all my stamp lines. And again, I'm going to start up here at the lightest area, and I'm going to activate my watercolor pencil. You can see that I haven't done anything yet here. So as I blend the watercolor pencils like I did with the other sample, I'm blending in the twinkling H2Os. And the purpose behind this is that the twinkling H2Os give this product, give your finished sample a really nice look. Gives it a nice glimmer. And for this little turtle that I'm going to have swimming in the ocean, that's a good thing. A little bit more here, and then we're just about done. Just blend that a little bit more. I don't know if you'll be able to see the glimmer in the camera. Can you? Katie, not really?
A little bit.
Well, you can tell in real life that he's got a nice shine to him. Now, I'm going to take a second color. In order to clean your brush, you just run it across some paper. I'm going to take this second color, this blue color, because he is a sea turtle, and I'm going to blend some of this blue in here. Just kind of highlight it a little. Give the shell a little bit more of a raised look to it when it's dry. And a little bit on his nose. Again, I'm going to clean off my brush so I can blend this. let it dry. And when it's all done, I'm going to put it on a pop dot and make this card right here. Now this card uses the turtle die cut, this, as well as the turtle plants or weeds or whatever you want to call them that come in the turtle die cut set. I've also added a couple of coral die cuts from the fish set, and something new is the flourish. And this flourish is from the With a Flourish stamp set, but it's a die cut. And the easiest way to use this die cut, I'm going to show you that too, because this die cut is a very fine die cut, it's kind of hard to stamp on. So what I've decided to do is a direct-to-paper inking method with this die cut. So I've got my die cut, and I'm going to, instead of stamping on it, I'm just going to take three inks, and they're all ColorBox chalk cap size, and I'm just going to tap over it. Just to get some nice color on there. And because this is such a fine die cut, this is much, much easier than trying to stamp on it. And if I wanted a whole bunch of color, of course, I would just use more ink. But I want something light and kind of shiny there. Oops, getting a little heavy there, aren't I? Oh, I like that. There you have it. Pretty, isn't it? This is Pamela from FireCracker Designs by Pamela. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you have lots of time for stamping. See ya!